Hi, before this video, you should already understand the words and concepts found in financial statements. Now, when I say financial statements, we normally mean the balance sheet and the income statement. Alright, so welcome back to MBAbullshitDotCom. The topic for this video is the price-earnings ratio, also known as the P-E ratio or P/E ratio, which is one of the market value measurements in financial ratio analysis. So remember, you can always go back to MBAbullshit.com. Alright, so let's get down to it. So this video discusses and analyzes the price earnings ratio, one of my free videos on liquidity, profitability, and market value. And that includes, so these ratios include these ones over here. After this, you can check out my next videos on MBAbullshit.com/such as my next video on financial leverage, which includes these ratios over here, and yet another video on turnover ratios, which includes these ratios down here. Alright, so now let's start. Now, I'd like to start with a story. Okay, let's say that ABC Company's share price in the open market is $100, and last year's earnings were $10 per share. What is the price-earnings ratio? Very simple. Now, you'll notice that in financial ratio analysis, computing the ratio is the easiest thing. Okay, it's the easiest thing to do. What's more important is how you interpret or analyze or understand the ratio. So anyway, the price earnings ratio here is simply $100 divided by $10. Where did we get the $100? That's the share price. Where did we get the $10? That's last year's earnings. Okay, last year's earnings declared, of course, the news comes out this year about last year. And our price earnings ratio is a very simple 10. What does this 10 mean? Well, it means that the ABC stock is selling in the market for 10 times its earnings. That's all it means. Very simple. Now, how do we use this? Is this good or bad if ABC comes? Or rather, do you prefer to have a high price earnings ratio, like maybe 20, or a low price earnings ratio, like maybe 6? All right? Which is better? Well, a low price earnings ratio can be good because it means that the stock is selling for cheap and therefore the stock is good value for investors. However, a low price earnings ratio can also be bad because you have to ask yourself, why is it selling cheap? Maybe they're expecting bad news in the future or bad news in the near future and the company has problems, and that therefore the stock must be sold cheaply, or therefore people are willing to buy it only at a cheap price in the stock market. Now, conversely, a high price earnings ratio can be bad because that means it's expensive and not good value for investors. But a high price earnings ratio can also be good because we must ask ourselves the question, why are people willing to buy it expensive? Okay, why are people willing to buy it expensive? Maybe because it has good forecasts. Maybe because we're expecting good news in the near future. Maybe because the company or people are expecting the profits and sales to go up. So why are people willing to buy it expensive? Now, sometimes you might find a very good stock with a low P/E ratio. So why is it cheap even if it has a low price earnings ratio? Well, maybe because this stock has not had much news or not many news reports about how good the stock is. That happens, okay? That happens. Sometimes a stock might have a high price earnings ratio even if the forecasts are not too good. Why? Simply because it's a popular share of stock. Everyone talks about it. It's always in the news. The CEO is a celebrity, okay? Something like that, and because of that, a lot of people buy it even if it does not have good prospects or good forecasts. So it might have a high PE ratio. So the best, of course, is to buy a stock with a low price earnings ratio with good forecasts, but which is selling cheap simply because it is not hot in the news right now. That would be a better formula for buying stocks, not simply because it has high price earnings ratio or a low price earnings ratio. Okay, now how do we analyze the price earnings ratio traditionally? The first is to compare the historical price earnings ratio of this company with the price earnings ratio now. So if the price earnings ratio is higher now than in the previous years, then this indicates that the company is more expensive now than before. This could indicate lousier value for investors, or it could indicate good earnings estimates in the future, and that's why it's selling expensive. Now, if the price earnings ratio is lower than in previous years, this indicates that the company is cheaper than before. So again, this could indicate better value to investors, or it could indicate bad earnings forecasts. Or sometimes it just has to do with the overall stock market. Sometimes all stocks in general tend to have, or most stocks in general tend to have price earnings ratios, and that's when we're in a boom phase, you know, boom or bust. When the economy is good, everyone's buying stocks, or a lot of people are buying stocks. The price earnings ratios of all companies, or of most companies in general, go up. When the economy is bad, people are feeling negative about the stocks and stock market. Then the price earnings ratios, even of good companies, tend to go down, and you can find better value stocks at the you can find better value when buying stocks at that time. But anyway, in this case, for traditional analysis number one, if your price earnings ratio is lower than last year's, then it indicates that your company is cheaper than before. So this could indicate better value, or it could indicate bad earnings forecast, or any other negative sentiment in the market. Traditional analysis number two is to compare the price earnings ratio of this company with that of other similar companies. Like if it's a bank, you also want to compare the price earnings ratio of your company to another bank, to the price earnings ratio of another bank. Okay? So if your price earnings ratio is higher than theirs, then this indicates that your company is relatively more expensive than other companies, other similar companies, based on earnings. This could indicate bad value to investors, or it could indicate good forecasts. That's why people are willing to buy it higher. If your price earnings ratio is lower than theirs, then this indicates that your company is relatively cheap, or this company is relatively cheap compared to other companies based on earnings. This could indicate good value or bad forecasts for the company. All right. So, therefore, I would recommend, if available, I would recommend a better indicator if you're actually investing in stocks. A better indicator would be what we call the forward PE, or the forward price earnings ratio, where the earnings over here, the number that you input here, is not based on last year's earnings, but it's based on next year's estimated future earnings. Of course, that's not yet sure, but it's just based on an estimate. So you find the future estimated earnings for next year, and you put it together in this ratio over here, and you get what we call a forward PE. Alright, so I hope you learned something. Remember to share it if you like it. Please follow me on Twitter. My name there, my Twitter handle is simply MBAbullshit. Or go to join my Facebook fan page so that you can get the latest updates and my latest videos. Just go to facebook.com/MBAbullshit. Or simply forward my YouTube links on your email or social media, or other social media. Have a great day, and goodbye.